It wasn't a missile that made the U.S. Navy back off. It wasn't a submarine, a fighter jet, or even a show of force. It was silence, broadcast across frequencies no human ear could hear. In the heart of the South China Sea, one of the most hotly contested waterways on Earth, a quiet but powerful ship appeared on the horizon. And just like that, the American ships changed course. This wasn't a warship with guns blazing. It was China's newest electronic reconnaissance vessel, the Type 815. Sleek, unassuming, and packed with sensors rather than missiles, it became the center of a high-stakes naval drama that few outside military circles even noticed. What makes this even more surprising is what the Type 815 represents. It's not just a ship, it's a signal. A signal that the information battlefield has moved to the ocean and China is staking its claim. So what's so special about this vessel? Why do rival navies turn cautious when it appears? And how did China, once mocked for its outdated fleet, suddenly build one of the most feared electronic surveillance ships in the world? Let's find out. Not long ago, the South China Sea looked very different. U.S. Navy surveillance ships regularly cruised its waters. American reconnaissance aircraft flew loops just miles from Chinese shores. These weren't attacks, but they were loud signals. We're watching you. And for years, China had little choice but to watch back, quietly, passively, and often helplessly. Back then, China's naval forces were aging and limited. The country was more focused on land-based defense and economic growth. But as territorial disputes grew sharper, especially around islands and maritime zones, Beijing realized it needed more than fishing boats and Coast Guard cutters to assert its claims. It needed eyes, ears, and presence at sea. Over the past decade, China began one of the most aggressive naval modernization efforts in modern history. It didn't just build more ships, it built smarter ones. Warships, aircraft carriers, and submarines rolled off assembly lines at record speed. And in this wave of growth emerged something more subtle, but arguably more strategic, the Type 815 reconnaissance ship. This ship is more than steel and circuits. It represents a shift in mindset. China is no longer just reacting to Western surveillance, it's actively shaping the information game. The Type 815 can listen to enemy signals, track ship movements, and relay real-time intelligence back to command. It's China saying, "We see you too. And we're not just watching, we're ready." In disputed waters like the South China Sea, where tiny islands can trigger global conflict, that shift from passive to proactive is everything. The Type 815 isn't here to start a fight. It's here to make sure China never walks blind into one again. At first glance, the Type 815 doesn't scream threat. It's not covered in missile launchers or flanked by fighter jets. But that's what makes it so dangerous. Like a quiet observer in a room full of shouting generals, its power lies in what it hears, sees, and understands, without ever needing to raise its voice. Stretching 130 meters long and weighing around 6,000 tons, the Type 815 is about the size of a football field. Its sleek structure features a long bow that leads to a helideck, giving it space and stability for long missions at sea. But what really catches the eye are the three massive spherical domes on its deck. Radomes that protect and house some of the ship's most sophisticated sensors. These radomes act like the ship's ears, constantly scanning the horizon for signals. Think of them as giant satellite dishes, only built for war. They can intercept enemy communications, track ship and aircraft movements, and even analyze radar emissions to identify what kind of weapons or systems an opponent might be using. At the front of the ship, an advanced optical-electronic system sits like a high-powered telescope, able to detect even slight movements on the water's surface. This system isn't just watching, it's calculating. By precisely measuring angles and distances, it can lock onto targets and relay their location with pinpoint accuracy. Inside, the ship operates like a floating command center. Technicians and intelligence officers sit at consoles decoding signals, mapping enemy activity, and transmitting reports to naval headquarters. Data flows in real time, turning the Type 815 into a nerve center that sees what satellites might miss and hears what aircraft might overlook. The ship also includes a helicopter pad, allowing for rapid deployment of scouts or rescue missions, extending its reach even farther. It's not just a spy ship, it's a mobile surveillance base, able to monitor, assess, and adapt. In a world where the first strike is often digital or electronic, the Type 815 is China's way of saying, we'll see it coming, and we'll see it first. Most people think of reconnaissance ships as floating antenna farms, passive, unarmed, and focused only on gathering intel. But the Type 815 breaks that mold. It's not just eavesdropping on enemy navies. It's preparing for a fight if it has to. This ship doesn't just observe, it can engage. The Type 815 is equipped with light missiles and torpedoes, which is unusual for a reconnaissance vessel. This turns it into a hybrid machine part intelligence center, part combat-ready warship. Picture a scout who can not only report where the enemy is hiding, but also call in an airstrike or take the shot himself. Its main strength is still electronic, but in modern warfare, that's exactly what makes it dangerous. It can jam communications, confuse enemy radar, and distort electronic signals. Imagine a battlefield where your opponent's radios stop working, their drones lose control, and their targeting systems suddenly misfire. That's the chaos the Type 815 can create. During operations, it plays the role of forward scout. It can position itself ahead of the main fleet, detect threats early, and share that data instantly. It also works closely with drones, submarines, and even China's rocket force. It can mark targets with precision, feed coordinates into missile systems, and support a strike, all while remaining at sea for weeks at a time. This versatility gives China a major edge. In a conflict, the Type 815 doesn't have to shoot first to win. It can blind and confuse the enemy, protect its own fleet, and pave the way for other forces. It turns information into power, and power into action. And that's why Western navies don't treat it like just a surveillance ship anymore. They know that when the Type 815 shows up, it's not just watching, it's shaping the battlefield. For many naval commanders, seeing the Type 815 on the horizon is like spotting a silent referee with a camera, recording every move, ready to report back to headquarters, and it changes everything. In recent years, the mere presence of this ship has caused serious disruptions in international naval drills. Take, for example, the joint U.S.-Japan exercises in the Western Pacific. These were large-scale military operations meant to display strength and coordination between allies. But when the Type 815 appeared just offshore, without a single weapon fired, parts of the operation were suddenly scaled back or called off entirely. Why? Because both navies knew they were under a microscope. Every radar ping, every aircraft launch, every radio signal was being monitored, recorded, and possibly analyzed in real time. This isn't just about privacy, it's about tactical exposure. When the Type 815 is nearby, any war game could become a data goldmine for China. It learns how different navies move, how they communicate, and how quickly they react. That intelligence can be stored, studied, and used to build better counter strategies. Even more chilling, the psychological impact. When a ship like the Type 815 appears, rival fleets don't just change tactics, they change behavior. Commanders go quiet on open channels, cancel exercises, and adjust routes. It's like a ghost haunting the waves, not attacking, but always watching. And that constant pressure builds stress in already tense waters like the South China Sea or near Taiwan. In essence, the Type 815 redraws the invisible lines of engagement. It forces navies to assume they're being seen, heard, and possibly targeted at all times. That alone can reshape military planning and shift the balance of power without a single confrontation. In the past, naval dominance was measured in firepower. Who had the biggest guns, the fastest missiles, or the most submarines? But that game is changing fast. Now it's not just about who can strike. It's about who can see, hear, and control the digital battlefield before anyone else even knows what's happening, and that's where the Type 815 is blazing a trail. This ship isn't just floating radar, it's a central node in China's expanding web of electronic warfare. At its core is a sophisticated system that can tap into the electromagnetic spectrum, listening to enemy communications, jamming radar signals, and scrambling electronic guidance systems. In modern warfare, this is like switching off your opponent's vision while turning up your own to full brightness. What makes the Type 815 even more formidable is how it links up with China's other military branches. It's not acting alone. During joint drills with the Air Force and Rocket Force, the ship doesn't just observe, it coordinates. It tracks missile trajectories, relays targeting data, and feeds surveillance directly into battlefield simulations. This real-time connection between sea, air, and land units creates what experts call integrated warfare, a seamless, fast-reacting military machine. Even more advanced capabilities are on the horizon. China is already integrating drones, both aerial and underwater, into missions involving the Type 815. Think of it as a mothership guiding a swarm. UAVs can scout ahead, dive below, or even hover over key zones, feeding back images and data. With AI and automation on the rise, future versions of the Type 815 might operate with even fewer crew, staying at sea longer, covering more ground, and reacting faster than any human could. This ship isn't just preparing for the next war. It's shaping what the next war will look like, one where battles are won not just with weapons, but with information dominance. Zoom out for a moment. The story of the Type 815 isn't just about military tech. It's about a shift in global power. For decades, the open seas were dominated by Western navies, especially the United States. Surveillance ships and aircraft from Washington patrolled critical waters with little resistance, gathering intelligence and projecting strength. But the rise of the Type 815 marks a turning point. It's China's way of saying, "We're watching now, and we're not backing down." This vessel represents a new kind of deterrence, not through overwhelming firepower, but through constant observation and presence. Wherever it sails, it brings with it the weight of a nation's ambition and confidence. It doesn't need to fire a missile to make an impact. Its presence alone changes how rival fleets behave. Exercises are canceled, routes are altered, plans are reconsidered. That's real influence. And this influence fits squarely into China's broader maritime strategy. The South China Sea, the Taiwan Strait, the Pacific Corridors, they're all critical to global trade and regional stability. By deploying ships like the Type 815, China is quietly but firmly asserting its claims. It's not just defending coastlines, it's projecting intelligence power deep into international waters. More broadly, the ship reflects China's growing mastery of information warfare. This is the new front line, where data is as valuable as ammunition, and electronic eyes are as powerful as carrier fleets. The Type 815 is part of a larger message that China will no longer accept being monitored without doing some monitoring of its own. In short, this ship is a statement. A message to the world that the age of Western naval surveillance supremacy is fading and a new multipolar era is rising. One where technology, strategy, and intelligence, not just muscle, define who leads on the high seas. If you found this insight valuable, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more deep dive stories on global defense and geopolitics. Until next time, stay informed.